She fidgets, the uneasy movements a telltale sign of the anxious thoughts that flit through her mind. The last 9 months have been difficult. In December 2016, Sarah, not her real name, was diagnosed with kidney failure. Doctors prescribed 2 weekly dialysis sessions to keep her on her feet, sessions which she initially depended on the National Hospital Insurance Fund to help her pay, even when she moved to a smaller private hospital. Every Wednesday and Saturday, Sarah, a mother of two, has undergone dialysis, which cost 9,500 shillings a session. But last Saturday, a worker at the facility made a shocking announcement.
Manager wa daktari akasema alikuja kama wagonjwa tuko tunaendelea na dialysis akatupatia hizo bills zetu alafu akasema nini wako na shida upande wa NHIF huwa ilipi sasa wanashindwa vile watatuhudumia. Lakini wajatufuguza, walituambia tu sasa beginning from this week, tukienda na cash.
This meaning that she now owes the hospital 161,500 shillings for the last 17 sessions, a sum which Sarah, a trader, cannot raise. This the predicament faced by several patients depending on the NHIF to cushion them from high healthcare bills. A section of patients report that in recent weeks, they have been turned away from facilities that used to accept their NHIF cards. Others, like Sarah, were asked to pay in cash. The NHIF, they were told, had failed to remit funds.
I've not heard about it, and I would wish to tell those members, if you have a problem with the facility or with your card, please contact our offices.
The hospital fund has contracted about 9,000 healthcare facilities to provide services to an estimated 24 million beneficiaries. NHIF attributing its challenges in remittance of payments to reports of fraud, where patients reportedly make multiple claims for their treatment sessions.
To this end, in the last 1 month, the processing of claims to facilities more or less slowed down due to heightened internal verification, which is a temporary situation which we've been addressing with the concerned members from the various healthcare providers and setting out what we need to do to enhance our internal controls and have integrity in that process.
If you have claimed fraudulently, you will not be paid. And that is a normal business process.
The owner of one such health facility, who did not want to appear on camera, however, claims the facility has not received any payment from the NHIF since June, putting it in a precarious position as the nurses' strike continues to exert pressure on private health facilities. For Sarah, a reprieve, the NHIF promised to review her case, enabling her to resume treatment. Wilkie Sanyabwa, The Big Question.